Hello everyone, our today's topic is class 11, unit number 3, chapter 8, cell, the unit of life. In this we are going to see the structure of a prokaryotic cell. So this is a structure of a prokaryotic cell. We know prokaryotic cells are morphologically the most primitive cell and they seems to appear about 3.5 billion years ago. A prokaryotic cell is essentially a single membrane or one envelope system. The membrane surrounds the cell. And inside, if we see, there is no membrane bounded organelle. Even their nucleus does not contain any membrane bounded structure. Their genetic material is naked. If we see the structure of this prokaryotic cell shapes, so the prokaryotic cells are found in four different types of shape. These are the four different types of shape. Let us see what are they. The first one is coccus. Coccus means spherical in shape. So bacterial cells can be found in spherical in shape. And that structure is called as coccus. It can be monococcus when it is single, diplococcus when it is in two, triplo when it is in three, tetra when it is in four, and so on. It can be, the next shape is bacillus or bacilli. That is rod-like. Again, it can be single rod, it can be group in two, it can be in group of four. If it is in single, monococcus, monobacillus. If it is in two, then it is diplobacillus, and so on. Then it is vibros. Here, the shape of this cell is in form of comma or small curved rod. Then is spirilla, that is in the form of spiral or twisted. So the bacterial cell is found in four different types of shape, and these are the structure of the shape and these are the name. Then let us see the components of the bacterial cell. First let us see the salient feature. They are unicellular prokaryotic cell present in different shape, size and arrangement. They lack nucleus and membrane bounded cell organelle. Even their DNA is found in cytoplasm, does not consist of any protective layer, and these bacterial cells are 10 times smaller than a human cell. Now let us see its structure. If we talk about the structure, a bacterial cell is covered by outer slime layer or capsule. You can see over here the outermost layer, which is called as capsule or slime layer. Then the middle layer is called as cell wall, and the inner layer, inner membrane, that is plasma membrane. Let us talk about the slime layer or capsule first. Outside the cell wall, this is the cell wall, and outside it, in a gram-negative bacteria, there can be a coating of micromolecule called glycocalyx. It may be loose gelatinous sheet termed as slime layer, or it can be a tough covering called as capsule. So if it is in form of gelatinous sheet, it is called as slime layer. If it is in form of tough sheet, it is called as capsule. Below it, there is cell wall. Let us see what is cell wall. So below this capsule or slime layer is the cell wall. Cell wall provide definite shape and give strong structural support to keep the bacterium from bursting in hypertonic solution. So the cell wall maintains the shape and size of the cell. Chemically, the cell wall material is material in all eubacteria or cyanobacteria is made up of peptidoglycan or murine. So there is a special chemical from which it is made, and it is called as peptidoglycan or murine. And the slimy layer or outermost covering is called a slimy layer or capsule, and below it there is a cell wall. After cell wall, there is the third layer, which is called as plasma membrane. Plasma membrane is the innermost layer of the cell envelope, and it is an absolute requirement of all living organism. It is found in all the organisms. It forms the boundary of the cytoplasm. So below it, there is a cytoplasm present. The membrane is semi-permeable in nature and responsible for the relationship of cell with outside environment. In general, the plasma membrane in prokaryotic has the same structure as that of eukaryotic cell. So we have completed the outermost layer of the bacterial cell. हमने इसमें देखा कि एक बैक्टीरियल सेल जो है वो अलग अलग शेप एंड साइज में पाया जाता है, और चार मेन शेप्स हैं इसके, कोकस, बैसिलस, वाइब्रस और स्पाइरिला। फिर हमने देखा कि इसकी जो आउटर मोस्ट लेयर है एक बैक्टीरियल सेल की, उसकी तीन लेयर्स होती हैं। सबसे पहली लेयर को हम स्लाइम लेयर या कैप्सूल कहते हैं, उसके अंदर मिडिल लेयर सेल वॉल और उसके अंदर सेल मेम्ब्रेन जिसको हम प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन कहते हैं। जो स्लाइम लेयर है वो जिलेटिनस शीट की होती है तो उसे स्लाइम लेयर कहते हैं, और अगर टफ होती है कवरिंग तो उसे कैप्सूल कहा जाता है। उसके नीचे सेल वॉल प्रेजेंट है, सेल वॉल एक स्पेशल केमिकल की बनी है उसे मुरेन कहा जाता है, और उसके नीचे नेक्स्ट लेयर जो होती है प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन जो साइटोप्लाज्म को बाउंड करके रखती है या उसको सराउंड करके रखती है। इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल सी सम अदर स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ दिस प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल। थैंक यू।